Patrick Ferguson, born in 1744, was a Scottish officer in the British Army and the designer of the Ferguson rifle. He is best known for his service in the 1780 military campaign of Charles Cornwallis during the American Revolutionary War in the Carolinas. Ferguson had an intense interest in musketry and firearms. It was a science which actually had made little progress for almost 100 years. The British Army was still armed with the cumbersome Brown Bess, which had been the standard infantry weapon, a smooth-bore, muzzle-loading flintlock musket, 3 feet 8 inches long in the barrel and weighing 14 pounds. The piece had an effective range of little more than 80 yards, and it took considerable practice before a man could shoot 3 rounds a minute. Ferguson created a marksman's lightweight rifle that could be fired with speed and accuracy while advancing or even from the prone position and weighed just 7.5 pounds. Initially, Ferguson could fire 4 rounds in 60 seconds at a 300-yard target. Eventually, he increased the rate of fire to 6 shots a minute. He even hit the bullseye at 100 yards, lying flat on his back. For his efforts, King George sent him to North America to recruit and be in charge of a sharpshooters corps. Ferguson's first mission was searching for General George Washington's division. Ferguson and 3 of his riflemen advanced past the British lines when they heard the sound of horses approaching. Taking cover, they observed 2 riders ride directly in front of them, a French officer followed by a colonial officer with a large cocked hat mounted on a bay horse. Ferguson's first impulse was to shoot down the 2 horsemen, and he signaled to his men to get ready to fire. But almost immediately, he signaled again to hold their fire. Ferguson was a typical British soldier, and the soldier's mentality is such that he feels a certain sympathy towards his enemy. To attack and overpower him in the heat of battle was all in the line of duty, but to play assassin and shoot him down unsuspecting and in cold blood was not part of the tradition of arms in which he had been raised. Ferguson stepped out and ordered the French officer to dismount, but both riders turned and rode away. It was recorded later that Ferguson said, "As I was within that distance at which in the quickest firing I could have lodged 12 balls in or about him before he was out of my reach, but it was not pleasant to fire at the back of an unoffending individual who was acquitting himself coolly of his duty, and so I let him alone." It was some time later Ferguson was wounded and in a hospital when he learned that one of the riders he didn't shoot that day was none other than General George Washington himself. How different history would have been if Ferguson had taken that shot. This episode of The Gun Doctor is sponsored by Smokin' Gun Worx, a nationally 5-star rated range and smoking hot deals. For The Gun Doctor and Smokin' Gun Worx, I'm Tim Bivens.